Hello friends, welcome to Knack Graphics. In this video, we are gonna draw this pattern of dotted circles. Let me give you a brief of this design first. They are circles and the stroke is replaced by the dots, which are precisely equidistant from each other. A dotted circle can be useful to you in static images or illustrations, or you can use it for animation purpose as well. A very good friend and so far my inspiration, Mr. Rajiv, gives amazing tutorials on animating objects and motion graphics in Microsoft PowerPoint. His channel's name is The Teacher, and he has made a tutorial on animating dotted circles as well. Read the description below to find the link to his video. I've also provided the download links of this design in different formats that may be useful to you if you want to import it to Microsoft Office applications, Adobe's Animate or Flash, Adobe's After Effects, Photoshop, and many other software. So let's start drawing this. We'll start with the innermost circle, which will have four dots. Pick ellipse tool, change the fill to none, and black stroke color is good. Change the stroke size to 10. Now come to the center of the artboard. Press Alt key and click once here. Enter 40 as width and height. Okay, now go to the stroke panel and change the cap option to be round cap. Now tick this option of dashed line. Enter 0 for the dash column, and now the gap between the dashes is to be precisely calculated. We want 4 equidistant dots for this circle, so brace yourself for some math. We entered 40 pixels as width and height of this circle. That means 40 pixels is the diameter of this circle, and hence the radius is 20 pixels. Therefore, the circumference of this circle would be 2 pi r, that is 2 multiply 22 divided by 7 multiplied by the radius value of 20, which is 125.7143. And we want 4 dots, so divide this circumference value with 4, we get 31.4286. So we can safely enter the value for the gap to be 31.43, and there we have it. 90% of our job is done here, and now you have to repeat an action. This circle is selected here. Press Ctrl C to copy it and Ctrl F to paste in front. Now the copy in front is selected, and with this selected, go to the transform panel here. Make sure the constraint button is on. Here in width column, add 40 to it. Alright, now again copy this big circle and Ctrl F to paste in front and add another 40 in width here. Repeat this action for the number of copies you want. I'm fast forwarding this video and I have made 16 circles here. Finally, if you want to put all these circles to separate layers, go to the layers panel, select this layer, and in its options, click Release to Layers Sequence. So here we have each artwork on separate sublayers, and now select these sublayers and drag them out to make them independent layers. Alright, I hope you find this video useful. Leave a like for this video and don't forget to check the description below to find useful links as I mentioned earlier in this video. Goodbye for now.